Okay, first things first, so I don't misrepresent myself and have folks complaining about the wrong things.
I hate that.
Okay, I'm not complaining about physics in games in general. My gripe is only with physics-based puzzle games, which is weird in and of itself, because if you went back in time 10 years and you told me that I'd be sick and tired of physics-based puzzle games, I'd have told you there was no way. That's because 10 years ago, there was only one worth talking about, The Incredible Machine, and it was awesome. But making a physics game was a difficult thing to do, so there was no way that I'd believe that I'd be up to my elbows in them now. Heck, even 2 years ago when these things started showing up in earnest, championed by games like Crayon Physics and Tumble Drop, I still wouldn't have believed that the physics-based puzzler would ever be a bad thing. Because making a physics-based game requires complicated mathematics, meaning the few people who could pull it off would be smart enough to make a good game. They couldn't just throw something together on the weekend. But I should have seen it coming. I mean, physics are physics. All it takes is one person to write a simple-to-use library, and suddenly the bar for entry is way lower than anyone can throw together a game with realistic physics. That library is called Box2D. Now, I want to be clear, the creation of Box2D is a great thing. A really awesome achievement. I've used it a little. I've also tried writing Physics Engine for myself without it, and I can tell you I have nothing but respect for the people who wrote Box2D. But the problem is it's now too easy for any weekend shovelware developer to crank out a game that has the buzz phrase casual physics-based puzzler without half so much as a thought as to whether they're actually making a good game. I guess my complaint is this. When you give people 100% free range of motion and control, do you really have a puzzle game? I mean, looking for a similar example in real life, would you call beer pong a puzzle game? Or a round in the batting cage? No! These are games of skill, but that's what I feel like is happening. They're making games of skill and calling them puzzle games. Maybe my complaint's purely semantic, only it's not, because when you write a puzzle game, you go about it inherently differently than you go about writing a skill game, and the audience, well, me at least, plays them differently. If I'm playing a skill game and I suck at it, I can keep practicing until I get better, or just decide I'm no good at it and stop. But a puzzle game? I've got to beat that next level. There's some solution built in, and I've got to find it. And when I try something and I miss the goal by just pixels, well, I've just got to try again and make some minuscule adjustment over and over again and again when the right solution is actually way off from where I am. And I'm stuck repeating myself because I can't tell that I'm barking up the wrong tree. And when I finally do manage to get lucky, there's this sense that I couldn't possibly reproduce the solution again, provided I even remember what it was. This is no way to make a puzzle game. Good puzzle games have reproducible solutions. If you're making puzzle games, I want you to take a screen cap of that phrase, print it out, and bang your head against it every morning before you start programming. Reproducible, like science. Reproducible means once I beat a level, I should be able to turn around and play it again and beat it easier this time because now I know the trick. There was this one game that was calling itself a puzzler that was a match 3 in a tumbler, like those things that they mix balls up in so that they can choose a lucky winner. Luck is a lousy game mechanic. It was a bad idea in Alex Kidd. It's a bad idea now. Not every physics-based puzzle game gets it wrong. Many get it right. Here are a couple of good examples. I mentioned The Incredible Machine earlier. In that game, you could only place your set pieces on a specific grid. If you were off, you weren't fiddling with one or two pixel adjustments. You were off. You had to try something different. Fantastic Contraption is another good one because you don't have to be exact with your solution. Just get that red ball to touch the goal, even for a second, even if it only flew through it and you're good. Same with Auditorium. You don't have to be exact. In fact, the semi-randomness of the particle emission in Auditorium kind of encouraged you to find a broad solution, which is kind of comforting. I hope that with this, we will see the end of bad physics-based puzzle games, because I don't want to spend another 4 hours of my life playing another one of these, and heavens knows I can't just not play it when I see one.